Alright, for being one of the best single player games out there, Dark Souls has provided a lot with its online content, and I was being serious when the title mentioned a battle royale. In Dark Souls 1, and more notably in Dark Souls 3, there's an online feature called the Undead Match. After defeating the Gravetender boss, he drops the item Champion's Bones, and when burned at a bonfire, it unlocks the Undead Match, which is, well, a battle royale. Even the wiki says that. But you spawn in one of four arenas and fight to the death until one emerges victorious. There's also team battles, but that just doesn't compare. But another interesting mechanic involves one of the game's rarest enemies. In DS1, if a player dies with 5 or more humanity, and then fails to retrieve their bloodstain, there's a chance that it'll be turned into an enemy called a Vagrant. These weird crab things will travel to other players' worlds in either a good or evil form, and if not killed will move on to another player's game until someone defeats them, rewarding the player with a couple humanities. But Illusory Wall goes into much deeper detail, so check out his video. Another hidden mechanic also involves some nightmare bugs, and if you can get infected by one of the egg carriers, you'll start to scratch your head throughout a 5-minute period, and once your time is up, a friend will come out to say hi. And with your now egg head, Ingi will sell a cure as well as some spells, but it doesn't end there, and half of any souls you gain will go to our parasite. And after sacrificing a total of 100,000, your new egg hat will become much larger, and it replaces your kick with a parasitic stab attack. That does around 40 damage, it's not that good. But it is still a very cool feature. And actually, one of my favorites involves the cute, not cute, Majula pigs. And after killing them 12 separate times, they'll spawn as a much bigger and scarier undead boar. But since you're no casual, you'll just parry them 12 more times. And once done eliminating this entire family tree, an even bigger mini-boss boar will come to enact revenge. And well, your reward is 3 cracked red eye orbs. It's not bad for a hidden mechanic. But the love for pigs don't end there, and one of the hardest items to acquire involves leading a pig for 6 minutes throughout the Brightstone Cove, where at a grass patch he'll dig up the pickaxe weapon for you to enjoy. But it's not all about these poor pigs, and many of the lesser known features involve online play. And every time you hear the Bell of Awakening being rung, it's actually another player ringing it in their own world. And there's actually many mechanics similar to this. If you rest at a bonfire that was just kindled by another player online, then you'll be provided with an extra Estus flask. There's also these weird floating rings called resonance rings, which appear when a player in another world uses a miracle in the same area. And when near, they provide your own miracles with a little buff. There's also a kind of similar mechanic in Dark Souls 2, and throughout your playthrough, you'll come across many of these stone statues in varied positions. And if you didn't know, these are other players who have died to petrification and are now appearing within your own world. But let's move on to the game of the year, and in Sekiro, you're also rewarded for bullying the weak. And after performing either a bestowal or a blood smoke on one of these poor geckos, it'll enchant your sword with a variety of buffs. Now, depending on who you brutalize, the effect will be determined, some of which include a healing blood smoke as well as a poison bestowal, but a really interesting video by I Am Trash brought to light this hidden mechanic, so check it out. In Dragon Eyrie, you'll be met by a very angry dragon at the middle of this bridge, and when I encountered him, I thought it was just a scripted event, but that's actually not the case, and depending on if and how many eggs you crush, he will appear, with the more eggs destroyed, the less time you have to escape. While on the topic of DS2, these illusory rings make the pig journey seem like a cakewalk, and to acquire the Ring of Exalted, you must beat the game without resting at a bonfire. But that's the easier of the two options, and the Ring of a Conqueror requires you to beat the game without dying. These are insanely hard tasks with at least 19 bosses standing in your way, and what these rings do is make your left and right hand weapon invisible. It's actually pretty cool. But there's a lot of small features I appreciate in DS2 that I feel like add some personality from the development side, and an odd one is the second option to opening the Shrine of Winter. Usually you have to kill a bunch of bosses and light 4 bonfires, but this other option allows you to pay your way within, and if you've accumulated 1 million souls throughout your playthrough, the doors will open regardless of who you've defeated. There's also another interesting detail. And if you wear Veldstat's helm while fighting the Fume Knight, he will become enraged and immediately start his second phase, with full health. But unlike the last mechanic, From Software does try to help you, and they give you the tools to make the game easier. If ever struggling with the mimics, just throw an Undead Hunter charm at them, and they'll be fast asleep, snoring fairly loud with their mouth open, which conveniently enough allows you to reach in and obtain the loot. Another tool, as we all know, is setting the windmill on fire, which removes the poison water in Mitha's boss room. But did you know if you summon an NPC for help, they'll beckon to you and proceed to point to the windmill, signaling that you should burn this? Although without prior knowledge, I have no clue how people were supposed to know this. Now, message signs are a vital part of many playthroughs, and honestly, it's one of Dark Souls' most iconic mechanics. And if you didn't know, the Seek Guidance Miracle increases the amount of signs you see. Although there's an even cooler detail, and when using the miracle, it reveals messages left by the developers, some of which hint towards using the Storm Ruler or the Path of the Dragon emote. But this is a fascinating mechanic, especially with how little we see of the development side. As you know, online summon signs are used to summon other players for help against a boss or area, but what you might not know is that there are rare types of summon signs. We're all aware of the white, gold, and red, but there's also a black, which appears when a player uses the Eye of Death item while being part of Nito's Covenant. But there's an even rarer one that I've never seen, and it was surprisingly difficult to find photos of, but that's the Dragon Soul sign, which has a completely different design and lacks any of the spaghetti language. But it appears as a giant dragon eye when a player is part of the Path of the Dragon Covenant and uses the Dragon Eye item. But when accepted, it initiates a one-on-one duel to the death, rewarding the winner with a single dragon scale. Another interesting detail lies within DS2's corners, and like many other players, I thought it was just a glitch. But turns out, if you decide to attack, a holo will flash into existence and then die, dropping a variety of items. But there's more than 30 of these hidden within the game, and so far there have been two viable options for finding them. The first one is using a torch, which exposes their shadow, creating a dark silhouette. The second is wearing any piece of the Moon Butterfly set, which poisons anything around it, possibly exposing one of the invisible hollows. As some of you might know, in Dark Souls 1 you can overkill an enemy, and if you do 150% of the enemy's max HP in one hit, you'll gain 20% more souls, but many might not know this mechanic is also present in Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 3, and even Bloodborne, so Miyazaki is clearly a fan of this mechanic, and it has me wondering if it'll appear in Elden Ring. My guess is that it will. So we all love the lightning miracles, and they are a lot of fun, but something you might not know is if thrown into water, it'll create an AoE effect that, from what I tested on these slugs, do about 40% less damage. Another hidden bonus lies within the Black Knight weapons, and if struggling against any of the demon enemies or even demon bosses, use one of these weapons, which do 20% more damage against demons. That's a pretty good boost, especially if you're stuck on any of these bosses. Now, in Dark Souls 3, while fighting enemies, you might notice that you randomly gained an Estus, or even two of them. And in short, there's a hidden chance that you can gain Estus Flask from killing higher level enemies. There's also a similar mechanic in Dark Souls 1, where a hidden point system counts the amount of enemies you've killed, and after killing enough, you'll gain a bonus humanity. But there's a lot of depth to these mechanics that I don't know enough about, but there are videos out there if you're curious. But those are all of the hidden mechanics that I'm at least aware of, and it's pretty cool to see how many options you have outside of just getting good, and if I missed any, I'd love to know. But I appreciate you watching up until this point. Have a good one.